DIY. It's the show about DIY and hacks and how-tos that are done today. Today on DIY. Oh. Head's not being chopped off. All right, that would be good. Yeah. Okay. Today on DIY, we are going to be recreating the Belle costume from Beauty and the Beast, or at least the DIY version. If you don't have or want to use expensive Disney store costumes, or you can't find it in your size, like me, for a reasonable amount of money, this will be a good alternative for you. Okay, first let's start off with the base of this costume. The base of this costume is a yellow t-shirt that I got when I went to HCC's summer camp, but you can easily use any boxy yellow t-shirt. You don't want to go for a skin tight t-shirt, otherwise you're not going to get this nice loose effect. And I cut it so it reminded me of like the top of Belle's yellow dress, you know, because it's like an off the shoulder dress. And I like how it adds like a modest touch to the dress, so you know, no cleavage is like showing or anything. Also I added a cute white gathered dress over top of that just to make the skirt more flowy and also to hide the little bit of image graphic print that was right there. Again, I would recommend just using a plain yellow t-shirt, but you want to go for something boxy, like you would find at Michael's or Joann's, not something you would find at like Walmart or Forever 21, where it's really fitted. On the note of fitted, you do want to go for a cute fitted yellow dress. You can go for any really style that you want. I just use this yellow tank top like dress, because it's what I had. And I believe I got this at H&M. And so that's the main base. Oh, a little bit of this is peeking out, but that's okay. It just adds more character and more flowy to the skirt. I'm wearing pantyhose. These are a little bit darker than I would probably normally wear if I were like actually going out in public, because you know, my legs are nowhere near this dark. And to me, wearing pantyhose that are way darker than your actual natural skin tone is weird. It's like getting a really bad spray tan, in my opinion. But that's just me. If you do you, I do me, we all live in harmony. Okay. Anyway, moving on to hair. I did the classic half up, half down bun hairstyle, and I just kept my hair like in its natural way that I didn't put up in a bun, and then I added this cute little yellow headband just to add some more yellow to the outfit. And now it is time for the last two pieces. Some nice golden yellow shoes. In the original tutorial that I inspired this from, she wore just like nude heels, but I wanted to go for more accurate to the movie look wise, so I went for yellow shoes, because I know Belle wore like yellow shoes in the ballroom scene. Of course they were heels, but I think these go with the overall look better. And the final touch is my fancy gloves. Now, if you're shopping for items specifically for this, try to find yellow gloves. I don't know if you can find fancy yellow gloves anywhere outside of like costumes, stores, and pieces directly for Beauty and the Beast. Because outside of Beauty and the Beast, I don't think I've ever seen fancy yellow gloves. But if you can't find fancy yellow gloves, just go for whatever color gloves you can get. White would be best. If you can only find black, I guess that would be okay, so long as you wear some other black accessories, like shoes or something. And I think I put these on the wrong hands. Hashtag soap. My hands are just getting bigger. So that is my interpretation of the Belle costume. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode of DIY. If you think I should be Belle for Halloween, be sure to give this video lots of love, like, share, and all that good stuff, because whichever Halloween costume tutorial gets the most views by Halloween, that is what I will be for Halloween. So if you want me to be Belle for Halloween, share this video so it gets lots of views, like it, and all that stuff, so that it will be the most popular costume tutorial. And I will see you guys.